Today, let me introduce our new satellite finder, TM8511. First, let's start from the last generation, TM8500. It's a very simple model, quite easy to use and comfortable to take. How easy it is! Only select the transponder which you want to lock, with the up key or the down key, that's it. The left key, right key, and OK key have no any function. The so-called editing function only allows you to modify the value. No adding, no deleting, even no restoring the factory data. However, it is such a simple model that sold over 80,000 units in the past 5 years. For the same level of finder, this is a very good result. A year ago, we started planning a new model. How to improve the product under the current conditions to the limit, while still easy to use, has become our design goal. Now we did it. Here it is, TM8511. Before turning on the meter, we can see that the silk print on the case and keys have been well redesigned, much better than the previous generation. A phone jack is located on the bottom of the housing, that can be used to upgrade software and preset data. I will demonstrate it later. Pressing the OK key will show turned on the screen, but it will not turn on immediately, until the backlight is lit and the display shows loading. This can effectively prevent accidental startup. The basic layout of the screen is still similar. However, we added a satellite entry to select different satellites by left and right buttons. Up and down keys used to select the transponder of the current satellite. The specially set triangular arrows on the screen make these two operations very intuitive. Connect the signal cable, turn the dish antenna, waiting for the signal is locked. Well, that's it. Just added the concept of satellite, daily operation is still as simple as the previous generation. Please note that the screen not only shows the system and modulation of the signal being locked, but also shows a check mark. What is the use of this symbol? It tells the user that both the system and modulation values match the preset value. In this way, it can help us to some extent to determine whether the signal locked is what we want. This is our innovation. Wait, what can the OK button do? This is the easiest button to press and we should let it do something to avoid waste. Here we add a new feature, dissect switch operation. With it, this machine can be applied to a broader environment. You can see the triangular arrows that indicate the operation moved to a new position, suggesting you how to operate here. Use the left and right keys to select the type of switch that the signal passes through, and use the up and down keys to select the port number for signal access. Look, which port you choose, which port will output voltage, so that the corresponding LNB will work, pass the signal over. When you press the OK button to return to the working screen, the dissect icon will still be displayed on the screen, prompting you that this satellite signal came in through a dissect switch. I'll set 4 different ports to see the effect of switching back and forth between these 4 satellites. Very good. It makes sense to say that it is easy to use, for the most common operations have been demonstrated over. Let's take a look at its editing system. A complete set of editing operations should include modifying transponder parameters, deleting transponder, adding new transponder, and restoring factory settings. These features, which were not completed by the previous generation, are now here. Press the edit key to enter edit mode, the character at the cursor begins to flash. Left and right keys to move the cursor, up and down keys to modify the value, return key to cancel editing and exit, OK key to confirm and exit. These are very easy to understand. But you must have noticed that the system and the modulation are also displayed. Move the cursor here by pressing the key labeled small arrow, and use the up and down keys to modify it. As mentioned earlier, if the value obtained from the lock signal is the same as it is, there will be a check mark to mark the result of the match. Small tip, if you press the M key, you can jump directly here and modify its value. At this time, M means modulation. To delete a transponder, you can change the frequency to 0, and then press OK. Yes, You have to press a lot of keys to remove a transponder in order to let the software know that you are on purpose. Of course, for the sake of caution, the software will confirm it again before it is actually deleted. Look, a dialog box is coming out. We even implemented a dialog mode on segment screen. In particular, when you delete a transponder, which is the only one transponder of a satellite, the software will tell you that the satellite will be deleted too. A new transponder can be added by long pressing the edit button. Before going to the edit page, the software will ask you where the new transponder is being placed. Here, we choose a non-existent satellite so that we can add a transponder to a new satellite. Despite tossing it, don't forget we have restore factory settings can be used. Long press the set key with gear, it will ask you if you want to reset to factory default. The feedback of the backlight key and mute key are very straightforward. In detail, we added a mute icon at the top of the screen to identify the current state. This detail is small, but allows the user to clearly know the status of the buzzer and will not miss the expected locking alarm. At this time, M means mute. However, when you long press the M key, motor will be displayed on screen. This means that our little finder supports DISEC 1.2 protocol that can be used to drive motor. At this time, M means motor. Small triangle arrows tell the user can use the left and right buttons to do something. Press and release briefly, the motor starts and stops. It's the same on the right. When you need it to turn a large angle, you will naturally press a little longer. Release the button after a beep, you will find that both the animation and the motor are not stopped. Until you think it's okay, press the OK button to stop both of them. Please remember, anytime you want to stop the animation and motor, just press OK. That's it. The operation of the motor is the same, simple and intuitive. Sometimes you need to turn the dish antenna to the leftmost, the rightmost, or the middle position. Please try the two round keys with small arrow and the M key between them. It will issue a go to X command that allows the motor to go directly to the specified angle and automatically stop. At this time, M means middle. Wait, you mentioned go to X. Does that mean DISEC 1.3 is also supported? No, the user cannot view or edit the three necessary parameters, position of a satellite, local latitude, and longitude. Unless you can easily edit the data of the finder using a computer. The good news is, we have set aside this function to automatically calculate the angle of the dish by the preset data, and send the result to the motor. Press the M key again when the motor is on screen. A new icon appears at the top of the screen. The motor has started to turn. The position of the current satellite is displayed below the icon. Please take the slash as a decimal point and read it as 19.2, east. It is hard to show the letter W, so, we use W. I set two satellites to use the use F feature to see the effect when used. To be honest, this is not a practical feature for a segment screen, especially when there is no way to edit the local longitude and latitude. Maybe we will implement this editing function later, but now, we can only hope to use a PC side tool to make it easier. Yes, this is our Windows side editing tool, SatEdit. First of all, plug the cable into your PC, then at shutdown state, plug in the cable into the Finder's data hole and make sure that the contact is good, then turn it on. The order is important. The blue icon on the toolbar indicates that the download cable is ready, and the green icon indicates that the finder is ready too. Now that the button with the up arrow is valid too, we can click it to read the data from the finder to this view. Now, let's simply edit the local latitude. Press OK, type new value, then press OK again. Then click the button with the down arrow to write the data back to the finder. Very simple. But now this cable is not for each finder with one, but only for our distributors. So we did a super good new feature. Let the software enter an automatic service state to write data to every finder which connected to PC without tedious operation. When a finder is connected to PC, it will download the data automatically, then enter sleep mode again if the option was checked. It's so convenient. Especially when you have two cables available, the efficiency will double. If you can let it sleep remotely, it can also sleep by itself. By default, if there is no key operation for 10 minutes, it starts a 9-second countdown and enters sleep mode. During the countdown, you can press any button to cancel it. The 10 minutes can also be set, just click the gear button. When the user set this value to 0, the screen displays 00, which actually refers to infinity symbol. So you can understand that never shuts down automatically. Yes, we turn this feature off.